Elasticity of demand problem, model 1. Most of the times, problems based on percentage method is asked in the board examination. If you master these problems, you shall face the examination with confidence. I am going to give 9 models. Board cannot ask a model which is not given in this series. Well, we shall go inside the problem. Normally, in most of the textbooks, you will find this formula. Elasticity of demand is equal to delta Q by delta P times P by Q, where delta Q is change in quantity, delta P is change in price, P is initial price, and Q is initial quantity. This formula is absolutely correct, but to tackle a twisted problem, it is better to have an expanded version of this formula. The formula I suggest is elasticity of demand is equal to Q minus Q1 divided by P minus P1 times P by Q, where Q and P are the same as what you have already used in the previous formula. The other two are Q1 and P1. Q1 is new quantity, P1 is new price. First, master this formula to solve the problems. This is more handy and convenient to attack any problem on percentage method. With this understanding, we shall go ahead to solve the first model. The problem. The price of a commodity falls from 40 rupees to 20 rupees, resulting in an increase in the purchase of the commodity from 100 units to 140 units. Calculate the price elasticity of demand. Keep the formula in your mind and try to identify the values of the variables P, P1, Q, and Q1. First, state the given values. Initial price P, 40 rupees. New price P1, 20 rupees. Initial quantity Q, 100 units. New quantity Q1, 140 units. We have to calculate elasticity of demand. State the formula. Substitute the values. Simplify it. 100 minus 140 minus 40, 40 minus 20, 20. The final value is minus 0.8. In calculating elasticity, we normally ignore the negative sign and take only the absolute value. It is 0.8. It is less than 1, hence relatively inelastic demand. Our problem ends here. Practice as much problems as possible. We shall meet again. Elasticity of demand problem, model 2. Before we proceed with our discussion, let me make one thing very clear. My suggestion is meant specifically for ISE students. CBSE students have to master a few more models apart from this. Again, to ISE students, of the 9 models that I am going to give, first 5 models have a high probability to be asked in the board examination. Well, we shall go ahead with the second model. This is the problem. When the price of a good increases from 10 rupees to 15 rupees, the consumer buys 40 units. The price elasticity of demand is 0.4. Find the quantity he was buying. As usual, state the given values by keeping the formula in your mind. Initial price P, 10 rupees. New price P1, 15 rupees. Initial quantity Q, we have to find. New quantity Q1, 40 units. Elasticity of demand minus 0.4. Remember, by convention, you have ignored the negative sign of elasticity value. Now, while solving the problem, you have to attach it. If you fail to attach negative sign to elasticity, you will get a wrong answer. As we have to find the value for Q, write the elasticity formula by interchanging the sides. It's a good practice to keep the unknown variable on the left-hand side. In our problem, Q is unknown. You have to find its value. Substitute the values in the formula. Simplify. I shall explain simplification step by step, because most of the students commit mistakes in solving for unknown. Follow carefully. Keep Q minus 40 as it is because we cannot simplify it, but put them inside a simple bracket. It is always a good practice to use brackets at the appropriate places. 10 minus 15 minus 5. Keep the fraction, then this equal to minus 0.4. Write the next step to show that you are going to multiply each term in Q minus 40 with 10. Multiply minus 5 and Q, minus 5Q equal to minus 0.4. Multiply Q and 10. 10Q, place it. Multiply 10 and minus 40, minus 400, place it. Keep minus 5Q in the denominator, and this equal to minus 0.4. Take minus 5Q to the right hand side and multiply minus 0.4 and minus 5Q, 2Q. Look, when two negative values are multiplied, we get a positive value. Since in Q2, Q is unknown, take the term to the left hand side. 10Q minus 400 minus 2Q equal to 0. Take the constant 400 to the right hand side. 10Q minus 2Q equal to 400. Simplify. 10Q minus 2Q, it is 8Q. 8Q equal to 400. We want the value for Q. So take 8 to the right hand side. Left hand side becomes Q and the right hand side becomes 400 by 8, 50. Q is equal to 50. Initial quantity is 50 units. This is our answer. My request is never skip a step for two reasons. One, steps carry marks. 2. Locating the mistakes committed becomes handy. Our discussion ends here. We shall meet again in Model 3. Elasticity of Demand Problem, Model 3. Welcome to the third model. In the first model, all the base values were given, and we calculated elasticity of demand. In the second model, except the value of initial quantity, all the values were given and we calculated the initial quantity. In this model, we are going to calculate the new quantity, that is change in quantity after a change in price. With this simple introduction, we shall go inside the problem. The price decreases from 15 rupees to 10 rupees. Consumer increases his purchases from 40 units. The elasticity of demand is minus 0.75. Calculate the quantity after a change in price. State the values given in the problem. Initial price P, 15 rupees. New price 10 rupees. Initial quantity Q, 40 units. New quantity we have to find. Elasticity of demand, minus 0.75. In this problem, negative sign is given within a bracket. In case it is not given, don't forget to attach it. As new quantity is to be calculated, write the formula keeping unknown variable Q1 on the left hand side. Substitute the values. Let me explain the steps clearly. Multiply 40 minus Q1 with 15. Keep it in the numerator. Subtract 10 from 15. Multiply 5 with 40. Keep it in the numerator. Equal to minus 0.75. Multiply 40 with 15, 600. Multiply Q1 with 15, 15 Q1. Place them in the numerator. Multiply 5 with 40, 200. Place it in the denominator. And minus 0.75. Take constant 200 to the right hand side. Multiply minus 0.75 with 200. Minus 150. Keep in mind, when a negative value and positive value are multiplied, we get a negative value. Take 600 to the left hand side. The positive 600 becomes negative 600. Negative 150 and the negative 600 are added. Negative 750. Negative 15 is taken to the right hand side. Negative 750 divided by negative 15, 50. Keep in mind, when you divide one negative value with another negative value, we get positive value. The new quantity is 50 units. This is the answer. Quantity after a change in price, Q1, 50. Once again, I tell you, never skip steps. Don't be carried away by overconfidence. Practice basic operations in mathematics. Our lesson ends here. We shall meet again in Model 4. Elasticity of Demand Problem, Model 4. This is the fourth model in this series. New viewers, view the first three models. Links are given in the description. Students, view all the nine models to get the full benefit. In this model, all the values except initial price is given. We are going to find the initial price. Keep track of the changes that are introduced in each model. This way, you shall be systematic in learning different models of the problems on elasticity of demand. The problem is this. When the price increases to 15 rupees, the quantity demanded falls from 100 units to 80 units. If the elasticity of demand is negative 0.4, calculate the original price. As usual, state the given values. Initial price we have to find. New price 15 rupees. Initial quantity 100 units. New quantity 80 units. Elasticity of demand negative 0.4. As we have to calculate initial price, write the formula as given in the lesson by changing the sides. Substitute the values in the formula. 100 minus 80 over P minus 15 multiplied by P over 100 equal to negative 0.4. Remember, if the negative sign is not given in the problem, you have to attach it. 100 minus 80, 20. 20 multiplied by P over P minus 15 whole multiplied by 100 equal to negative 0.4. Simplify it. 20P over 100P minus 1500 equal to negative 0.4. Take 100P minus 1500 to the right hand side and multiply it with negative 0.4. Simplify. 20P equal to negative 40P plus 600. Take negative 40P to the left hand side. 60P equal to 600. Take 60 to the right hand side. 600 over 60, 10. P equal to 10. Initial price or original price P, 10 rupees. We shall meet in part 5 of the series. Elasticity of demand problem model 5. This is the 5th model in this series. New viewers, please see the first 4 models. Links are given in the description. Students, view all the 9 models to get the full benefit. Once again, I remind you, there is a high chance for any one of the first 5 models to be asked in the ISE board examination. In this model, all the values except new price is given. We are going to find the new price. Keep track of the changes that are introduced in each model. This way, you shall improve your learning different models of problems on elasticity of demand. Now the problem. Consumer buys 50 units at 5 rupees per unit. After an increase in the price, he buys 40 units. The elasticity of demand is 1. Find the new price. First, state the values given in the problem. Your success depends largely on identifying the values properly. Initial price 5 rupees. New price, we have to find initial quantity 50 units, new quantity 40 units. Elasticity of demand negative 1. Negative sign is not given in the problem. We have to attach it. As we have to calculate new price, write the formula as given in the lesson by changing sides. Substitute the values in the formula. 50 minus 40 over 5 minus P1 multiplied by 5 over 50 equal to negative 1. 50 minus 40, 10. 10 multiplied by 5 over 5 minus P1 whole multiplied by 50 equal to negative 1. Simplify it. 50 over 250 minus 50 P1. Equal to negative 1. Take 250 minus 50 P1 to the right hand side and multiply it with negative 1. Simplify. 50 equal to negative 250 plus 50 P1. As we have to find the value for P1, rewrite the equation by changing sides. Negative 250 plus 50 P1 equal to 50. Take negative 250 to the right hand side. Simplify. It is 300. Take 50 to the right hand side. 300 divided by 50 is 6. P1 equal to 6. The new price is 6. Okay, we shall meet in part 6 of this series. Elasticity of demand problem model 6. Welcome to the 6th model. The 3 models following this one will strengthen your facing the board examination with more confidence. How? Follow the lessons, you will understand all by yourself. The problem. A consumer buys 5 units more when the price falls from 50 rupees to 45 rupees. If the elasticity is 2, find the quantities the consumer buys at 50 rupees and 45 rupees. First, state the values. Initial price 50 rupees, new price 45 rupees, initial quantity it is not given, we shall have it as Q units. New quantity not directly given, the problem says the buyer buys 5 units more than before after a fall in price. If the old quantity is Q units, then new quantity must be Q plus 5 units. Elasticity of demand negative 2. See, in the problem, the elasticity is 2. Negative sign is not there. We have to attach it. Don't forget. Good. As we have to find initial quantity Q and the new quantity Q1, we have to interchange the sides of the formula so that the unknowns are on the left hand side. Substitute the given values in the formula. Q minus within bracket Q plus 5. Don't forget to put the value Q plus 5 inside the brackets. 50 minus 45. 50 by Q equal to negative 2. Remove the bracket. Q, negative 5. Note, when you remove the brackets, positive Q becomes negative Q, positive 5 becomes negative 5. 50 minus 45, 5. 50 by Q equal to negative 2. Let us further simplify. Positive Q and negative Q gets cancelled. Negative 5. Divide by 5. 50 by Q equal to negative 2. Negative 250 over 5Q equal to negative 2. Take 5Q to the right hand side. Negative 250 equal to negative 2 multiplied by 5Q, negative 10Q. Since Q is unknown, let us interchange sides. Negative 10Q equal to negative 250. Taking negative 10 to the right hand side, we have negative 250 over negative 10, 25. Q is 25 units. Then Q1 must be 25 plus 5, 30 units. Initial quantity Q, 25 units. New quantity Q1, 30 units. Our problem ends here. We shall meet again in the 7th model. Elasticity of demand problem, model 7. This is 7th model in this series. For the benefit of those who didn't view the first 6 models, the links are given in the description. Now we shall go inside the problem. As the price goes up from 10 rupees to 12 rupees, the market demand falls by 12 units. The elasticity of demand is 1.5. Find the initial quantity and the new quantity. To start with, state the given values. It's a good practice. Initial price P 10 rupees. New price P1 12 rupees. Initial quantity, it is not given, we shall have it as Q. New quantity not directly given, the problem says the market demand falls by 12 units after an increase in price. If the old quantity is Q units, then the new quantity must be Q minus 12 units. Elasticity of demand -1.5. See, in the problem, the elasticity is 1.5. Negative sign is not there. We have to attach it now. Don't forget. Good. We have to find initial quantity Q and new quantity Q1. So we have to interchange the sides of the formula. See, the unknowns are on the left hand side now. Substitute the given values in the formula. Q minus within bracket Q minus 12. Don't forget to put the value Q minus 12 inside the brackets. 10 minus 12. 10 by Q equal to -1.5. Remove the bracket. Q negative Q positive 12. Note, when you remove the brackets, positive Q becomes negative Q, negative 12 becomes positive 12. 10 minus 12, negative 2, 10 by Q equal to -1.5. Let us further simplify. Positive Q and negative Q get cancelled. 12 divided by minus 2. 10 by Q equal to -1.5. 120 over negative 2Q equal to -1.5. Take negative 2Q to the right hand side. 120 equal to -1.5 multiplied by negative 2Q, 3Q. See, negative 2Q is shown within brackets. It's a good practice when two signs occur consecutively. Since Q is unknown, let us interchange the sides. 3Q equal to 120. Taking 3 to the right hand side, we have 120 over 3, 40. Q is 40 units. Then Q1 must be 40 minus 12, 38 units. Initial quantity Q, 40 units. New quantity Q1, 38 units. Our problem ends here. Please try to understand the difference between model 6 and model 7. We shall meet again in 8th model. Elasticity of demand problem, model 8. In the 8th model, we are going to calculate the original price and new price. If you are a new viewer, please see the previous videos. The links are given in the description. The problem: elasticity of demand is 0.6. Quantity demanded expands from 125 units to 130 units after the unit price falls by 5 rupees. Calculate the original price and new price. Well, it is always a good practice to state the given values to begin with. Initial price is not given. We shall have it as P. New price is also not given. But from the problem, we know the new price is 5 rupees less than the original price. If the original price is P, then new price must be P minus 5. Initial quantity 125 units. New quantity 130 units. Elasticity of demand -0.6. Note, in the problem, the negative sign is not there. You have to attach it. Again and again, I warn the students because most of the students commit mistake here and lose marks. We have to find initial price P and the new price P1. So we have to interchange the sides of the formula. See, the unknowns are on the left hand side now. Substitute the given values in the formula. 120 minus 130. P minus within bracket P minus 5. Always keep expressions like P minus 5 inside the bracket to avoid mistakes. P over 125 equal to negative 0.6. In the next step, remove the bracket and simplify. 125 minus 130, negative 5. P minus P plus 5. See, the positive P becomes negative P and negative 5 becomes positive 5 while removing the brackets. P over 125 equal to negative 0.6. Simplify. Negative 5. Positive P and negative P cancel each other, so 5. P over 125 equal to negative 0.6. Negative 5P over 5 multiplied by 125, 625 equal to negative 0.6. Take 625 to the right hand side. Negative 5P equal to negative 0.6 multiplied by 625, negative 375. Negative 5P equal to negative 375. Take negative 5 to the right hand side. Negative 375 over negative 5, 75. P is 75. Then P1 is equal to 75 minus 5, 70. Initial price P, 75 rupees. New price P1, 70 rupees. Our discussion ends here. We shall meet again in model 9. Elasticity of demand. Problem, model 9. In the 9th model also, we are going to calculate the original price and the new price. If you are a new viewer, please see the previous videos. The links are given in the description. The problem, market demand contracts from 33 units to 22 units. After the price goes up by 4 rupees. If the elasticity of demand is 1.25, find the initial price and the new price. To begin with, state the given values. Initial price is not given. We shall have it as P. New price is also not given. But from the problem, we know after a change in price, the new price is 4 rupees more than the original price. If the original price is P, then the new price must be P plus 4. Initial quantity 33 units. New quantity 22 units. Elasticity of demand negative 1.25. Note, in the problem, the negative sign is not there. We have to attach it. We have to find initial price P and new price P1. So, we have to interchange the sides of the formula. See, the unknowns are on the left hand side. Now, substitute the given values in the formula. 33 minus 22. P minus within bracket P plus 4. Always keep expressions like P plus 4 inside the bracket to avoid committing mistake. P over 33 equal to negative 1.25. In the next step, remove the bracket and simplify. 33 minus 22, 11. P minus P, negative 4. C, the positive P becomes negative P and positive 4 becomes negative 4. When brackets are removed. P over 33 equal to negative 1.25. Simplify. 11. Positive P and negative P cancel each other, so negative 4. P over 33 equal to negative 1.25. 11 multiplied by P, 11P over negative 4 multiplied by 33, negative 132. Equal to negative 1.25. Take negative 132 to the right hand side. 11p equal to negative 1.25 multiplied by negative 132, 165. It is always safe to keep negative 132 inside the bracket when two signs occur next to each other. 11p equal to 165. Take 11 to the right hand side. 165 over 11. 15. P is 15. Then P1 is equal to 15 plus 4, 19. Initial price P, 15 rupees. New price P1, 19 rupees. Our discussion ends here. This completes this series. We shall meet again in the next episode.